Hey guys, we are at the new Norcross Library. This is the first in a series of videos that I'm going to take on the library construction, and we'll kind of show you what's happening on site and then talk a little bit about the theory of the design. I'm standing over in the corner. This library is unique because it's sitting on top of a parking garage, and so half of the library, or I should say, half of the parking garage supports the library, and the other half supports a green roof on top. And you have to start by digging in the dirt, and you dig footings, and we've already poured a number of footings, and you can see here they have the rebar going up for a column, and this is a retaining wall down in the parking area, and they formed up for it. You can see the rebar here, and they've got the panels ready, and later today they're going to be pouring some of these walls. The parking garage is going to have spaces for 136 cars, so that is all the car capacity we need for a library that's 22,000 square feet, and that's kind of typical for a library that's that size. But what is different is this parking garage, and being in Norcross, we are on the edge of Lillian Webb Park, and you can see over here they have a new four-story residential development that is going to be right next to our elevated plaza area, and this forms kind of an alleyway in between our building and the parking structure. So here we are in the last bay. We're actually standing in some parking spaces, so cars will pull in right here, and there'll be some nice landscape strips through here. Let's see if we can walk over this way. It rained on Wednesday, so the ground is a little soft. But as long as I've done this, it's always kind of amazing to see something start to come together as far as the scale and the size. You can see they're pouring some concrete over on the other side of the parking area. That will be the entrance where the concrete truck is. That's where you'll drive down from Britt Avenue and come into the parking structure. This is a center aisle right here, and then we're in another aisle here. These walls that you see are concrete walls, but they're shear walls, so they're taking up some of the lateral loads that will take place in the building. And you can start to see the column layout. They've got all the rebar turned up to start preparing for the concrete columns over here. They've got some of the columns already in place. Here's what the rebar looks like. You just simply go through and you tie all the rebar together. You can see the ties there. And a structural engineer designs all of this. And then at the top, you tie those rebars into the slab. So everything is nice and secured together. But we're going to be doing concrete for about 6 months. This project should take 14 months. It's going to be interesting with the virus to see if that gets extended out any, and with the weather, we've had some rain. But the first 6 months is pretty much just pouring concrete, doing what we're doing right now. This is another shear wall, and this is the edge of the structure, and you can see Beaufort Highway over there. We pulled the building up to the street, kind of create a street presence. And if you look back, you get the edge of the park. But here they are, these guys. They're over there tying up rebar, pouring some concrete today. It's a beautiful day, about 75 degrees, a little light breeze. Let's, I'll go up to the park and let's take a video looking back down. So here the guys are pouring one of the concrete footings over along Britt Avenue. So what they do, they have a vibrator that they put down in the concrete, and what that does is that gets out all the air bubbles so that you have a nice consistent mix. If you're not familiar with concrete, it's not as much of a liquid as a lot of people imagine, it's kind of a thick substance, and it does flow, and it does dry pretty quickly, but you can see over the other side of the footing that the concrete is thick enough where it doesn't actually flow over to the other side of the footing. So this is forming a footing for one of the columns. One of the columns that'll support the library above. We're under the library right now. And you can see here how the rebar from the column is tied into the rebar for the footing. They hold the rebar off the ground with the concrete bricks. That's just to kind of protect it from rusting over time. Truck now pulling away. In front of us, we'll have an elevator from the street, and you'll be able to go down to the parking level and then go up half a level to the library plaza. You can really see the footings here. This is some of the rebar that they have. This is some of the rebar here for the column tops, and we've got rebar here for the footings. You can see how large the footings are. That's the site. Up here to the right, we'll have a plaza. And that plaza will open up onto the park. It should be a fantastic place to sit and just kind of watch everything that happens in the park. I'll see if I can walk up there and show you the view. Here we are. You can see Buford Highway and the new residential development. So here we are at the park level. This will be about the finished floor level of the library. And here's the Lillian Webb Park. Right here in front of us. They've just done a fantastic job of framing the park on all sides with residential. The park's really a nice amenity for these people that live in homes here. And then just over the hill is the old historic downtown Norcross along the train track. Got our job site sign here, looks good. It's lunchtime, people taking a little break. Well, that's it, guys. That was the first video for the Norcross Library. I'll continue to post videos of construction along the way and continue to talk about progress and some of our thinking about how the library came together. I hope you enjoyed watching. Stay tuned, and we will see you next time.